In this video, we'll talk about the white spot disease in aquaponics. So welcome in this video. Today, a topic very interesting. We're going to talk about disease, fish disease, and we are going to talk about a specific one, which is called the white spot disease. So the white spot disease that we have in aquaponics is called actually ichthyophthirus. It's the name of this parasite because it's a parasite that is growing on the skin of the fish. And it's very different to what you can hear on the prawns. Sometimes you hear that some prawns have some white spots. This is white spot virus. Completely different. The white spot that we're going to talk about today is a disease that can happen in our fish, on the surface of our fish, on the skin of our fish, on the fins, and in the gills of the fish. So this disease has got a very complex cycle, and it's very well known from aquarium keepers because it's very common disease to see in aquarium. So when we talk about white spot, we talk about the trophones. That's the spot that we can see on the surface, on the skin of the fish. And those trophones, they are actually one part of the cycle of this parasite. So the trophones that we see on the fish, they are actually unkisted. They form a cyst on the fish. And it's like a shell that is around them and protect them. So they are on the surface of the fish, but they are also in the same time eating the fish, taking the energy from the fish. So unfortunately, they develop on the fins, on the skin, but also on the gills. So the fish is weak, but also is not able to breathe properly because he's got so many of these parasites on the gills that basically it needs to breathe way more quickly. And you can really see it when you see a fish that is sick, that is affected by this parasite. You can see that he is breathing quicker than normally. So obviously the fish can take a certain number of parasites, but when it increases in number, it becomes unmanageable and the fish energy is gone and it just dies. So how can we, what can we do in aquaponics basically? So here behind me, I got one setup where I got some little fingerlings in this one. I got some Murray cod fingerlings and few silver perch, and they are affected very deeply by this disease. So the idea, normally in an aquarium, you would add some chemicals such as permanganate, potassium permanganate, malachite green, methylene blue. The problem of those is that they are very toxic. In aquaculture, we would also use formalin. So all those things are toxic. You don't want to put those type of chemicals in your aquaponic systems. Otherwise, it's going to remain in the system, and at one point or another, it's going to finish in the veggies, and you're going to consume it. So it will be really, really bad. You definitely don't want that. And anyway, in aquaponics, my idea is to produce some food that is healthy and organic, right? So I never add any chemical in the system. So how are we going to get rid of those? I have to admit that it's going to be very challenging. So the first thing to understand is that when it's in one setup, if you have several setups like me, what I want to avoid is to mix some water from this affected setup to another one. So any equipment that I dip into this aquaponic system, I'm not going to dip it into the others, right? I'm going to use specific net for this setup. If I have to act on the setup with my hands, I'm not going to go then and play on the other setup. I have to have a good segregation, good hygiene, to not affect the other aquaponic systems. It makes sense, but you need to keep it in mind. That's the first thing, right? You don't want the disease to spread everywhere. So now I got this disease of white spot there. What is important is to understand the cycle of this disease. So as I said before, you got what you can see on the fish. It's the white spot. But then this white spot is going to fall down and it's going to release a lot of little larvae. And those larvae, they're going to swim in the water and they are going to be looking for a fish. And this fish, if they find the fish, they're gonna attach on the fish and they're gonna form a new white spot. What is important to understand is that each white spot, the white spot that you can see on the fish, when it's detached from the fish, it's gonna fall down and it's gonna fix on the bottom of the tank. So when it's fixed to the fish, it's called a trophont. And then when it's released from the fish and it falls down, it's gonna fix on the bottom of the tank, it's called a tomont. And then from there, one tomont is gonna release thousands of little larvae. Those little larvae are called pterons or tomites. And that's those larvae that you can actually kill. The rest, you know, when they are encysted, when they are into the shell, once you see it on the fish, basically, you can't really kill it. It's like the parasite is protected. It's only the larvae that you can affect, you can kill into the water. So all this is going to create a cycle, right? It really depends on the temperature of your water. If your water is warm in temperature, it can the cycle can be completed in 3 days, 3 to 6 days. But if the water temperature is low, it's around 10 degrees, the cycle is going to take 30 days. So you understand that for 30 days, you need to treat the water. You need to make sure that you're going to kill the larvae when they are born. If you're able to do that, then theoretically, you kill the disease because the parasite is not able to complete the cycle. When it's encapsulated, when it's in this shell, it's not affected by the treatment we're going to put in the water, but when it's going to give birth to those larvae are going to be very, very sensitive to any treatment we can put in the water in aquariums. Or even if you don't put any treatment, they need to find a fish. If there is no fish, then they're going to die. So what you need to do if you have a water that is around 10 degrees is to basically treat your water for the 30 days if you're in an aquarium. But here in aquaponics, we're going to use a different technique. We don't want to put any chemical in the system. So what we're going to do, we're going to remove the fish for 30 days. If you remove the fish for the whole cycle, and if the larvae, when they are ready, they don't find a host, if they don't find a place to grow, they are just going to die. So that's the idea. We're going to fish the fish. Obviously, we're going to also add some salt. We're going to use a salt bath technique. So we're going to fish the fish, we're going to put them in a salt bath salt bath tank for a little bit of time, because on the fish you still have some little larvae that are trying to fix on the skin. They are not yet encapsulated, so this one we're going to try to kill them, and then we put the fish aside and we're going to keep them in an area where they are not going to be stressed for 30 days. During this time, we're going to heat the water in the tank. So if you heat the water, you increase the cycle of this disease, which means that instead of taking 30 days to complete the cycle, if you raise the water to 25 degrees, it can take from 3 to 6 days, which means every week we have one cycle that is done. So if we can keep the water 2 weeks and at 25 degrees without fish, we can imagine that all the little larvae are gonna die of starvation, and after that you can put your fish back. So let's try to keep the fish away from the tank for 2 to 3 weeks, even more if you can, but as long as possible, so that you don't have the disease anymore on the tank. And obviously we will have to treat our fish very often, making sure that we're gonna give them some salt bath to always give them some new water, and to always try to clean the fish from the disease they have on the skin. So it's not easy, it's not an easy task. Those fish have some high probability to die, but we're gonna do our best to save them, and we're gonna do our best to remove the disease from this tank. And the most important is to avoid to have the disease that spread on the other fish that we have, because we got trout, we got silver perch, so we don't want the fumaricoids here to spread the disease on all the fish. So this is up to me. I have to be very careful when I work from one setup to the other. I don't want to transmit some water while the tank is contaminated. So let's start, let's fish the fish, let's give them a salt bath, and then we're gonna put them aside in a nice dark area where they can relax. And I'm gonna find a heater to heat the water temperature of this tank while the fish are away. And I'm gonna push it at the maximum to have the cycle that is done quickly, and to basically starve those larvae and to make sure that they don't find any fish, and therefore they die. Let's get it started.
So let's dive into the tank. Make sure I got a nice aeration in this tank, because obviously the fish are going to be in a high concentration of salt. High concentration of salt means also less oxygen available in the water. Here I got approximately 100 grams of salt in those 10 liters of water.
Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it gave you a bit of information about this disease. The first thing is to obviously keep your fish in a good environment. That's the general idea of aquaponics. We want to avoid stress on the fish. If you avoid stress on the fish, you avoid most of the disease. But when a disease arrives, you're going to do your best to get rid of the disease and avoid it to spread on the different systems that you have. So that's exactly what we did in this video. Hopefully the fish are going to survive, but that's all we can do for this specific white spot disease. If you have any comment, please put it in the comment section of the video just below. I'm looking forward to hear your feedback. Also, if you are new to this channel, you can have access to a free guide to build your aquaponic system, but also to maintain it in the best way possible. It's in the description of the video just below, or in the I like information. It's an interesting training that I spent a lot of time to put together, and it's free, so just get access to it and start building your aquaponics system and have success with it. So once you get access to the free training, you will arrive to this page, and here you will have a detail of different steps, and each time you got a video or some description to really allow you to build some strong knowledge and to know and to learn the basics of aquaponics, so to avoid any mistakes. So just enter your email address and you will receive access to this training. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video. Bye bye.
Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!